Okay, this problem deals with an exothermic reaction conducted in a CSTR, and it's observed that on Monday the feed temperature is 350 Kelvin, but the conversion is 15%. And then on Friday the feed temperature is 345 Kelvin, but the conversion is now 80%. And so the feed condition is identical on the 2 days except for that temperature, and the question is, can that drop in temperature actually lead to an improved conversion, or did something else have to happen? Okay, and so typically what we would expect is that if we feed a CSTR with a lower temperature feed, if it is an irreversible reaction, then the rate of reaction and the conversion will always go down as temperature goes down. And so it doesn't make a lot of sense that a simple drop in temperature would lead to a conversion of 80%. All right, and so what we would expect instead is that maybe if that feed temperature is jumping around, if it went down, maybe it could have gone up. And we could have actually ignited the reaction and be operating at an upper steady state. And so if we remember that we can have an ignition extinction curve where we have, for example, the feed temperature, which we often will call T0, and we'll have the actual operating temperature of the CSTR. And we can have a region where we're operating at a lower steady state temperature, but then we have an ignition at a certain point, a higher temperature and higher conversion. And above that temperature, when we have multiple steady states, we would have a higher temperature steady state and higher conversion. All right, we then have a hysteresis effect where if we decrease the feed temperature now, say it went up, ignited, and then started coming back down, that we would stay at the upper steady state for a while until we reached the extinction temperature, at which point we would come back down here. So this would be our ignition temperature, and this would be our extinction temperature. And so one thing that would be consistent with this observation is that if initially we were operating at 350 Kelvin, we had an upset in the positive direction that led to an ignition event, and then said that we were operating somewhere in this region. All right, and then we cooled back down to 345 Kelvin, but we were still on the upper part of the hysteresis curve, so that we were operating at a higher temperature. And so one possible explanation for this data is that multiple steady states are possible, and then we ignited and ended up on the upper curve of this ignition extinction curve.